Hey everyone, it's your friend Think Noodles, and welcome to Ask Think episode number 169 for Monday, February 1st, 2016. And this morning I woke up and I was like, okay, I have to do Ask Think this morning. And then I was like, oh, there's 28 days in February, so the next episode will be March 1st. But there is 29 days this February. It's a leap year, guys. So I guess it'll be like March 7th, something like that. Anyway, last month, the question for you guys was, what is the most important lesson or life lesson you've learned thus far? And we'll start with hashtag Forever Inspired. And it says, what I've learned is not to give anyone you don't know your information online and not trust anyone you don't know. And that is a huge lesson that I hope all of you have learned and learned at a young age that your parents taught you this, because this is really, really, really important. You don't want to be sending any personal information to anyone you don't know personally. The internet is so far reaching, and people can seem like someone online that you would trust and talk to, and you know, they could be someone completely different than what they say they are. And if you give them personal information, could get dangerous. So that's a really, really great lesson to learn. And I'm glad your parents taught you that, or I hope you learned it from your parents and not from personal experience. The sloth guy says, I've learned not to run in the street. I was not hit by a car. I was running and I tripped over my big feet and fell on the asphalt. I was so scratched up. I looked like Two-Face with my scrape because it's only on one side. And I had big feet as a kid as well. I actually still do for my height. Because I'm not super tall. My dad is 6'2", but I'm only like 5'9". But I wear a size 12. So I've got big feet for my height. And when I was a kid, I think I had size 12s probably, I don't know, maybe by eighth grade. And I was very short back then. So I had huge feet and I tripped over them a lot. And I did the exact same thing. I was chasing a friend. I ended up falling on the street, but I was chasing a friend. I think we were playing tag or something. I don't know. We came to the edge of it was someone's yard, one of our yards. And, there was like a big step, but I didn't quite catch it right, and the tip of my foot caught the step. I don't know, maybe it was about 2 feet off the ground, and I thought I was going to jump, but I didn't because I caught my foot. And yeah, I face planted right on the sidewalk and broke my nose. So I learned that one as well. Anti-Troll 1000 said, one of my most important lessons I learned was not to believe everything I see or hear. It's helped me a lot to gain a better sense of making sure to question anything that doesn't sound true or believable. Maybe better able to discern right from wrong and truth from lies. And that is absolutely true as well. Don't always, I mean, you can believe things that you see and hear, but not everything. And it's really important to grow up questioning everything. Well, not everything. Sometimes just listen to your parents, guys. Don't always question your parents. Like, you know, I don't know. I don't know if what you're saying is true there, Mom. I don't believe you. Some things you do need to believe. But other things, don't be afraid to ask questions. Cherry Pie says, the most important thing I've learned is to never give up. There's been plenty of situations where I just wanted to quit, but I persevered and completed it. Oh, and learning to breathe was also important. If I had not learned that, I'd be dead. And always, you know, things sometimes get hard and challenging. And yeah, push through it, because in the end, it could be more rewarding just for the simple fact that you knew that you were challenged even further than you thought you could go. Erica James says, the most important thing in life I've learned is not to throw rocks at your neighbor's window. It's a long story. And here's another one that I learned through experience. Long story as well, but there was no one living there. But yeah, throwing rocks at windows usually ends you up in a lot of trouble. John Bittetti says, the most important thing I've learned is that time doesn't wait up for you. I think this is because you only live once, and there are so many things to do in our lives, you only get one chance to do as much as you can. Also focus on the present, because the past is gone and the future might not be there. I learned all this because I always used to think about the past or the future, but never the present. And that is a great way to live life. I mean, also plan for the future. Don't just live in the present. Like, hey, I got $100. Who knows if I'm going to be here tomorrow? I'm going to go buy stuff. You know, kind of a little bit of planning for the future, but also don't forget to live in the present. Lizzie Beth says, question next month. Something I learned that is that I learned that sometimes I need to listen before I say something. One time I had a strong opinion when my friend was talking about something that annoyed me to the heart, and I told her my solution about this. It was a mistake. I didn't hear the whole story and ended up making things worse. I lost that friend, but a few years later, we're friends again, and that was lucky. This has shaped me to at least listen carefully to what's going on before I say something I will regret. And this is something that I know better, but sometimes it's really, really hard to listen all the way through, at least for me, before I interject my opinion. It is really, really hard, but it's a great lesson to learn. The Minecraft Bowtie says, the most important thing I've learned in my life is that you can put glow sticks in the freezer and relight them. Yep, my life is boring. Well, that is a good lesson for everyone else who really likes glow sticks. That 1J123 says, the most important thing I've learned is to understand your privileges and how to use them for the better. For example, education is a privilege. Use your privilege of education to become something great while advocating for those not as privileged. My mom has always taught me this by making me help others to succeed better in life. Wow, that is so responsible and caring about others. That is incredible. And what an amazing thing to have learned in your life. Most people, or many people, never learn that. Nabiha Ekiyaja, I tried, says that I learned that video games is not the most important thing. Now, guys, I was talking about lessons that you've learned in life that were true. And we got to go back to the person before who said, I don't believe everything that I see or hear, because this is absolutely not true. Video games are life. No. Okay. You're right. They're not the most important thing. They aren't. But they're pretty important, at least to me. Marius Brossard says, the most important thing I learned is that you only get one life. And again, not true. Well, I guess it depends on what game you're playing. But most games, you have three lives. Or look at Super Mario Maker. I got 100 Mario challenges, so I have 100 lives. I mean, what game are you playing that you only get one life? Oh, wait. Going back to the previous one, video games are not the most important thing. So you mean real life. Like, real life, you only get one life. And yeah, that's actually true. Okay. Slow-mo McKenzie said, the most important thing I learned is to lift up the toilet seat. I learned that from personal experience. You know, what I learned from personal experience was to put down the toilet seat after I was done. I learned that from personal experience from my sister. Chloe Waterside says, the most important lesson I've learned in my life is to not trust some people. I got hurt by my friend and took my other friends with her. It's why I have trust issues. And this is very similar to one of the most important things I've learned in my life, is it's not necessarily to not trust some people, but it's to figure out who is trustworthy and to trust the right people, because you can't go through your life not trusting anyone. You have to trust people to get through life. It's just learning to understand and figure out the right people trust. All right, guys. Now the question for next month comes to us from Luke Aulette, and it is, what is your favorite retro video game? And that's games before 2000. For me, if you were asking me that question, if I said retro video game, or if you asked me a retro video game, I would automatically go to before 1990, but I'll let you guys go with before 2000, and let's see what you guys come up with. Oh, and also put why it's your favorite retro video game. All right, guys, before we get to the questions for me, don't forget to leave your question in the comments below so I can have something to answer next month. Remember, only one question per comment, but you can leave as many comments as you like. Also, if the comments on this Ask Think are closed, go to the most recent episode of Ask Think and ask your question there. Now, the first one comes to us from Star727, and it asks, how did Kobe get stitches and when? So if you guys have been following me on Twitter or Instagram, and if you don't, link in the description, but I've been posting pictures of Kobe, and you notice she has a couple of patches where she had surgery. And she had it like 2 weeks ago now, actually, because we took her stitches out. And she had a few like cysts and things, and one of them was concerning, not from a cancer perspective, but the vet was concerned that it would rupture and that could be a problem. So we had them all removed at once, and everything came back. Nothing is cancer. She's A-okay. She's just a little cold because she's got a bald patch on her butt. Monster High Fan 2014 asks, what's your favorite Sharknado movie? Mine's the first one. So if I had to think about it, I think Sharknado 2. The first one was really funny. I just feel like the second one just really took it over the top. And then the third one was kind of like, I think it was a letdown to me as compared to the second one. Tabby in Boots asks, do you see yourself having another career as fun as this? Probably not. A lot of my friends or anybody I talk to about what I do, and lately I've been seeing a lot of dentists, and periodontists, oral surgeons and things, and they always ask, okay, you know, when can we do this? And I'm like, oh, well, you know, I work for myself. And like, oh, what do you do? And I tell them, they're like, you can do that? That sounds really fun. Like, do you ever have a bad day at work? I mean, how could you possibly have a bad day at work? So yeah, probably not. I think there are very, very few careers or jobs that are as fun as being a YouTuber. Glitterpaws, a 456 lover, says, hey Fink, I swear every time I go to New York, I see you walking Kobe, but I'm a little shy to say hello. Do you mind? Because my aunt lives in Manhattan. I don't mind. The thing is that Kobe really, really likes the taste of children. So, no, I'm kidding. It's absolutely fine. She loves kids. She loves everybody. And I am happy to talk to you and hang out with you and let you pet the dog and all that stuff. So go on, say hi. I don't mind at all. Madeline King asks, Think, have you ever been on a cruise? Just wondering. Yeah, my wife and I have been on a couple of cruises. One was like a carnival cruise, and we went, I think it was just Mexico. It left from New Orleans. Remember that. And then we went on another one, but I mean, it was a dive cruise kind of in the Maldives, but it wasn't like a huge cruise line. There was only, I'd say, 10 or 12 passengers. Herobrin Dude says, hey, Think, this is for you. Have you ever programmed any computers or used Python, C++, JavaScript, or HTML, etc.? Just wondering. Yes, I have. I did a lot of programming classes in my undergrad. Actually, we programmed in C++, not Objective-C. I don't think Objective-C was, that didn't exist then. No C#. We also learned, we did some Java programming, but it was still very light. And I learned JavaScript and HTML when I was doing my websites and stuff. And we did learn HTML in college as well, but that was pre-JavaScript. Let's see. So yeah, I mean, I definitely have learned, and I do. I did a lot of PHP programming as well. Jackson Vance asks, Think, what's your favorite NBA team? Mine personally is the Cavs. Well, okay, so this is kind of a, there's two answers to this question for me. So my favorite NBA team is still the Lakers, even though I'm having a pretty rough season. almost last place, but I still love them. The thing is, they're not very entertaining to watch this season. So my favorite NBA team to watch is the Warriors. They are an amazing team, and it's just entertainment just to watch them and just, you know, see them drop those shots. You're just like, what's, like, how does that even happen? So favorite team is still the Lakers. Favorite team to watch this season are the Warriors. It's Iron MC asks, Think, do you play Factions, and are you still partnered with the Parents Garage? No, I've never played Factions, and as far as the gaming on my Parents Garage, I am. Not necessarily with the server, but I signed a, well, I guess it was almost a, okay, no, it was over the summer, but I signed a contract with them and provided them with 15 episodes of my, you know, Think's Gaming Minute segments for their second season on the Disney XD channel. Killer Pirate 02 asks, what do you record Wii U games with? I want to start doing that soon, but I don't know what to use. I use an Elgato HD, and the commentary, the reason the commentary goes off, it starts off even, but it starts to fall off because of editing software. Basically, the Elgato records with a variable frame rate. So if there's a lot of action on the screen, it might record at a slower frame rate. And then when you put it into a video editing timeline at, say, well, 60 FPS, it sees the lower frame rate and shortens the length of the video, and therefore the commentary starts to come after what's happened in the game. Or is it before? I guess it's shorter framed. Either way, it starts to come off sync. I wish there was video editing timelines that supported variable frame rate. I'm not aware of any, at least in the editing that I do. I know that Premiere and Final Cut Pro both don't support it. That's what it comes from. It actually is recording properly. It's just the video editing timelines can't support it properly. Why Fox Plays asks, think, do you ever use WineBottler or VMware to emulate a Windows PC on your Mac, or is it all just Mac game that you can play? Do you think OBS is a good program for recording? I think OBS is a great streaming software, and I think it's pretty well respected for recording. But as far as WineBottler or VMware, I don't. The reason I don't is because Macs are basically PCs in a different shell. They are PCs in a different shell. They are Intel software. They've got, I've got an NVIDIA video card in my iMac and everything, and I have a separate partition for Windows, and I boot into Windows 8.1 when I want to play Windows-based games, because when using VMware or WineBottler, emulation software slows down gameplay, and if I want to play a game that's graphically intensive, I will boot over to Windows, or that's a Windows game that's graphically intensive, I'll boot over to Windows and play it there and record it in Windows. The Forians says, think, I have no idea how to record iPad games. Do you use an Android, or is it some conspiracy that Apple's yet to discover? The recording software that I use, Voila, when I'm on the Mac side, it has, all I do is plug in the USB cable into the back of my iMac, and it pops up and says record iPad. I think you can also do it without Voila through AirPlay mirroring, and you just play it on your iPad and you record your screen and it shows up on your screen. Lifeless Koopa says, think, I'm planning on starting a YouTube channel and I kind of want it to be somewhat successful. 100,000 subscribers will be great, so I was wondering, how do you start and get this far with a million subscribers? I think anybody who starts a YouTube channel would want it to be successful, so you are in good company. However, the way that you start is, first of all, find something that you really like, that you really want to play, because I'm assuming you're doing gaming, but it's got to be something you really like, because in the beginning, it's going to be frustrating that you're not getting the traction that you want. I mean, you want 100,000 subscribers, and the first 100 or first 1,000 are going to be some of the hardest to get, and it'll be frustrating, and you'll feel like you're not making any headway, and you're not getting anywhere. So if it's not something you're enjoying, you're going to have a really hard time continuing, because you're just going to get discouraged. I would say that if you're just starting, if you have a friend who's got a few thousand subscribers, that would be a great way to jumpstart your channel. As far as getting this far, it just comes from a lot of perseverance and, riding the roller coaster up and down. Snowy Pearl 9 asks, where's the series with James and Dan? It's almost February. Actually, it is February. February 1st. I mean, you did that 6 days ago, but still, you're right. You're right. The three of us have been so busy with, our own content on our channels that it's been really, really hard to get motivated to finish up the last little bit on the server, but I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it, or I'm going to force one of them to do it. Probably the latter. WaspMan101 asks, think, what is the benefit of playing your single-player world on a server rather than in a single-player world, and what do you use to host your server? I use a third-party service. I used to use Realms, but one, it doesn't support snapshots, and two, the view distance is only 9, and I like to put it up a little bit higher than that for my mob farms and things. But the benefit to playing a single player world on a server is that the server takes off a little bit of the processing load of your computer, like chunk loading and things, so you can get better frame rates and things like that, because your computer isn't the one doing the calculations for generating the chunks. The server that you're on is doing all that generation. Exploding Awesome Creeps asks, how come you don't show us you mining? Because it's boring, honestly. I showed a lot of it when I first started playing Minecraft, because I mean, I didn't really know much about Minecraft at the time, and it was mining was interesting to me, so I would show it to you guys because I was having fun with it. But now mining is, and actually, the other thing is, like on the Noodle Planet, I really don't do much mining. Honestly, it's not even that I do it and I just don't show you. I just don't do much of it because I've got my iron farm. I've got a ton of everything. I don't really need to go mining, so that's another reason that I don't really show you. Riley Phil says, I noticed on your older things, you used custom NPCs and the minions were actually retextured villagers. So how do you get an NPC to follow you with custom NPCs? This applies to even the minions mod. I use a lot of the time, I use a custom NPC for Kevin or Dave to follow me around. And the way that you do that is you go, I think it's when you create the custom NPC, you go to, the advanced tab. And then it's the first one. I don't know if it's a job. Whatever, it's the first one. Just change them to follower, their occupation or job, and then give them the item, and then you click edit, and then it asks what item you need to make them a follower, and then give them that and put 10 days or infinite, and then hand them the item, and then they will follow you everywhere. Sometimes when you don't want them to, but you can also disable that. Aiden Rocha asks, how do you download mods? Every time I try to do it, it puts a virus on my computer and just completely mess it up. Do you need a current kind of computer? A certain kind of computer, I think he asked. No, you don't. It's just that make sure you have good virus protection software. It's actually not the mods themselves that would be putting viruses on your computer. What it is the AdFly links are very, very misleading. And do have spyware and adware in the ads. So when you click on it on Minecraft Forum, it's going to take you to the mod, but it takes you to another site first to show you an ad. And a lot of times those ads are less than savory. So that's why. Galaxy DJ asks, will you ever do a video with fans on the Noodle Planet or something like that? I hope you do someday. I've done it before and I will do it again. I will do it with the ship, but I'm looking for something very, very specific for the journey, and I still haven't found it. Paul Webster asks, when you're asleep, you smell different than when you're awake. Why? What? Just an innocent comment. It's not like I stalk you. Winky. Well, maybe I... Okay, creepy! Okay, that... I think that's enough questions for today. I am going to go check all the closets in my apartment now, guys. So if you enjoyed this episode of Ask Think, don't forget to pick up those chopsticks and poke that like button as hard as you can. Also, don't forget to leave a question for me in the comments below so I can have something to answer next month. I'll see you guys again soon. Thanks for watching. And of course, Noodle on!